Hey folks, today on the channel I want to talk about climate change and farming and how they're linked together. And you know, this is, we're mid-February here in Quebec, where it's usually super cold and it's in the 50s Fahrenheit, above 10 degrees Celsius. There's no snowpack and it feels like spring already, which, you know, it's far from normal. And I don't think this is something that is like a one-off spin, because in the last 5 years, I've really noticed how just like the snow cover just isn't there anymore, even here. And, you know, cold temperatures, they just don't last. And for a lot of people, they could imagine, yay, that's great for you because you can get to garden year-round without any problems. But that's really not how I see it. And that's what I want to talk about today. There's a lot of folks out there that are conspiracy theorists that don't believe in climate change. I think these people should get more educated because they don't know what's going on. And the science is there. It's telling us that the snow caps are melting and it's inevitable. They're gonna melt in the next few years. And so that's gonna create a huge change. And the thing that I see that's gonna happen is big farming, like it's used to being done now in the last 60, 70 years, monoculture, using a lot of water, like big fields, fully mechanized, with a lot of migrant workers picking these vegetables that we find at the superstore. This model is not going to be able to survive climate change, because these fields of monocultured crop, they require too much water. And with the climate that is unstable, going from frost to super hot, going to super windy, tornado-like, to all these kind of variables, this climate that's always changing, which is the main result of climate change, these farms are not resilient. They're just not. And the answer to this won't be factory farms. The answer to climate change and food security is not factory farms. It's not hydroponic farms. It's not lettuce grown inside. The answer to this is more small farms, more diversified, ecological, resilient farms feeding communities. Tens of thousands, tens of millions of them everywhere, nurturing the soil, adapting to what's going on, and being the real guardians of food. And that's what the answer to climate change is. And no one is talking about that. It really, really bothers me that no one is saying this, because these farms are already there. A lot of them are actually doing the work. A lot of them are finding it very difficult. And they could get more support. They could get more funding. They could get more customer base, a bigger customer base. So, and you just need to take it for somebody that's been in the midst of it for all these years. This is one answer. Small farms, small, local, diversified, ecological farms that are resilient to climate change, multiply those. Make sure that we have a local food shed. Make sure that we have the guardians of their soil that are there to feed the communities. Factory farms, hydroponic farms are not the answer to the global food challenge that we're about to face. Take it from me. So anyway, this is how I see it. And obviously, I've been thinking a lot about this for the last 10 years, but I'm really curious to open up the floor and read your comments about this. You think I'm wrong with this? Do you think like there is a conspiracy? Do you think hydroponic is the solution to all of this? Like, I'd like to hear you out. And I'm pretty sure that we'll get some heated debate. So let's open up the forum to that. I'll read your comments. And otherwise, I hope you guys are growing. I hope you guys are well. I'm well. I'm disturbed. I really am. But it is what it is. I'll see you next time. JM out.